Hello everybody, welcome back. It's been brought to my attention repeatedly in the last few days that there's this whole big new thing on YouTube, which is basically people quitting YouTube. It's the next big thing, apparently. And I'm often, and always actually, oblivious to this kind of stuff. I have no idea what's going on out of these four walls where I'm just sit here and just trying to, you know, play something good on the guitar. But then, you know, you guys in the comments and on Patreon, the discussions there, and my musician friends and my students, sometimes they kind of remind me that there's a world out there. Spoiler alert, I'm not quitting YouTube, but I want to make this video because besides having people who are trying to learn how to be a musician, a producer, guitar players, so they come to me for basically knowledge on this channel, I also find that a lot of young people ask me, should I start a YouTube channel? Should I get into this? I really think that I have something to share, but I'm scared, I'm concerned, I'm worried about what people will think or say about me. And so that's something I take extremely seriously, just as seriously as I take the fact that if I make a video, maybe 10 years after I'm dead and gone, somebody excited about learning the guitar will pick up their guitar and look me up on YouTube and find my video. And then I will teach them something that's wrong, or I will share something with them that's a lie. It's just something that I had to make a video on just to keep my quota. And I would never do that. And when people ask me for advice, especially if they're young and they are looking up to me or to whoever as kind of a mentor, I would probably first suggest that they don't look up to me. But if they decide to do it anyway, I want to give them the best possible answers. And that's why I felt compelled to look into this and to dig into it. And there's a few reasons why people are compelled, so it seems, to leave YouTube. And the first one, though, is kind of the fake one. I'm going to get this out of the way right away. You know the videos, you know, oh, I never wanted to do this, or this is it, or this is the end, or goodbye, right? You know the ones. You watch them and the guy's not even quitting YouTube. It's just clickbait. Or sometimes they say they're quitting YouTube, but then 2 months later they're back. Or maybe they say they're quitting YouTube, but they're opening a new channel somewhere else. We're not going to waste time on that, so that doesn't concern us. But there are certain aspects of working on YouTube that are stressful and can be very stressful and detrimental for a lot of people. Now, to be honest, YouTube is a small, small part of what I do. I have music schools, I teach, I have a musical career, and you know, I do all kinds of stuff. So the money, the economics of YouTube is not, let's say, the main focus of my economy. So that's one thing that I want to put out there. So if you have a financial responsibility invested in YouTube, then it's a serious subject. So I'm not taking it lightly. I'm just saying for me, I can afford certain liberties that if you are actually making your living on YouTube, you might not be able to. So I completely sympathize with these problems. I don't want to take them lightly. But what I notice is, first of all, is a concept of the ever-changing waters, right, of YouTube. So you get some traction in what you're doing, and then YouTube changes. It changes because of the regulations, it changes because how much and how it pays you, it changes in so far as the algorithm goes. So 2 weeks ago everybody was watching Star Wars clips, but now it's all about, I don't know, whatever it is, it decides, well, quitting YouTube is the trend now. And so following those trends becomes extremely stressful. And I can understand that. I would never do it because I know what I want to make my videos about. But if you're trying to do this only for financial gains, then you kind of have to play the game. And if you play the game, it can be extremely stressful. At that point, my suggestion is always, you know, find something you love. It doesn't have to be YouTube, you know. I love YouTube because I can do my thing. I look at it as a legacy thing. One day I'll be gone, and if you want to learn the guitar, I'll be here yapping about, and you can learn everything that I've ever learned about the instrument, or as much as I can cram into these videos, and I know that I'll be useful to some people. But if I were trying to just, you know, ride this thing and take advantage of it and follow it, I would be going crazy, right? I would never be able to do it. I wouldn't want to do it. I'd rather be a psychologist like I studied for, or I go play somewhere or find any other job, you know. I don't want to be swayed so much and influenced so much by some random algorithm that nobody even knows where it comes from. So that's the first thing. And so if you do that, I think you'll have to accept that things will go well sometimes and go badly other times. It happened to me since I started out in music. You know, you never know how it goes. You might make some money on a certain project and the other project you think was great will give you nothing. You can make a video that gets a million or more than a million views, that will give you some money, and then the video you think is the best one might get 5,000. And so that's something you kind of have to accept. The other thing, and that's more of a concern to me, because when people ask for advice, they're usually young people, and not always though, but you know, a lot of them are. Like some of my students are very young and they say, I want to be a professional musician. Well, I take that very seriously, because the advice you give and the things you share, for some people, they are, you know, they're very, very important in the sense that they are formative. They make them, they help mold them into the adults that they will become. And so this worries me, which is the stress that comes from the exposure you bring on yourself when you release a video. So if you are a younger person and you want to try YouTube, your first videos will probably not be so great, right? And you'll be exposed right away the second you upload it, if you're lucky, because if you're not lucky, two people will see it. But if you're lucky, you start getting comments and you start getting dislikes and you start getting opinions. And these opinions have, of course, no values. Some of us know that, but for other people, they become part of their identity. And if your dream is to do this for a living, then you can't ignore those comments, right? A lot of those comments are a measure of how well you're doing. And it becomes this vicious circle of constant confrontation with other people's opinions of you, and you don't know them. And if some videos of mine get thousands of comments, imagine if I were to take them all seriously, right? And so that's a big thing, and I don't think there's a solution for it. I think we are built to have a small peer group that we have to kind of cater to. So we have to worry about few people. That's how we are designed as humans. We're social animals, but we're not infinitely social. We can't truly comprehend and manage and navigate the need to be accepted by, if I get a million views on a video, I can't expect to be accepted and loved by a million people. You know, that's just insane. And young people have a hard time figuring this out. You know, they say that it doesn't affect them, but a lot of people are extremely affected, especially creative people, who are people who then end up making music and videos. They are especially, you know, vulnerable to it. So that's one thing that I'm really concerned about. And the only thing I can say about that is that comments reflect the person making the comment. It does not reflect the receiver of the comment. And so negative comments are just really about the person who leaves them. And it's really a reflection of who they are and where they're at that moment in their life. And it's not something I would envy or I would worry about. And also you have to be prepared though to do the same with the positive ones. I have a very blessed situation on my channel. I think the average is 99.4 positive versus negatives. And basically all the comments I get are very positive. They might be an indication that I'm doing something right, but that's where it ends. You know, you don't take all that stuff seriously. And if somebody says, oh, you talk too much, or oh, you can't play, I don't care, right? I have no interest in carrying that along with me. So that would be what my suggestion, you know, just do what you want, put it out there. Don't edit comments, don't delete them, unless they're, you know, of course, offensive to others. But if it's about you, then let it be. You know, it's really of no consequence to you. That would be what I would have to say. The third thing that I find people are stressed about is, and a question I get often, is how do you find all these topics? How can you always have ideas to make your videos if you do once a week, twice a week? How do you do it? And I think the only solution to that is to only make videos about things you know. Right? About things you like, about things you are excited about. And then there will be no shortage of it. As a matter of fact, many weeks I have two or three ideas. Which one should I do? And my point for my channel is to help people play better. So once I have that, then it's easy for me to go, oh, that's a great exercise, or that's a great idea. Or if I'm writing a song, like, that's a good tip, you know, that somebody else might want to use if they're writing. Or if I'm mixing my record and something sounds great, I'll make a note of it and maybe somebody else will be able to benefit from it. So once you have a clear direction of what it is you want, and dare I say you're an expert, so to speak, at what you do, then you will have no problems coming up with topics and making videos in a very relaxed way, because you're talking about things you know. Now, I know people who have to make their schedule, maybe they're not quite there yet with their knowledge, and so they have to basically study for 6 days a topic that they really know nothing about, and then make a video pretending to know a lot about that topic, and then they live in the fear of being found out. They worry that people will know that they just are pretending. So you kind of get yourself into this strange and very unhealthy situation. So my suggestion again is, make videos if you have something you want to share. Make videos if you have something that might make a difference for other people. Make videos that will enrich other people or that will entertain people. Make videos with a purpose. If you do that, then you'll always have topics. And if you don't have a topic, well, you can skip a week, but you're not a slave to it. You're not a slave to the algorithm. Another thing I noticed, if you make one bad video or one video you don't believe in or one video you make just because you thought you had to make it, it's gonna come back and haunt you. And I don't think I've done that, or maybe I have, don't take my word for it, but I have found that I made some videos that I thought were great and nobody watched them for like 2 months, 3 months, 6 months, right? And then all of a sudden, boom, people start watching it. And that's the mystery of YouTube. And I always wonder, what if that was a bad video? What if I made a bad video and I could hide it under the rug, but then eventually YouTube says, you know what? Now everybody's gonna watch that video. And maybe that video will ruin all the hard work and the goodwill and all the community, the sense of community you've built on your channel will be destroyed, because that time or that other time you just tried to be something you were not, and you know, to fool your audience, just maybe to get some views or to make $3. Be yourself and do things you believe in, and find your mission. It doesn't have to be altruistic. Your mission could be, look at me, right? But follow that mission. And then the people who will find you will relate to you, and you'll be able to have a relationship with them, which is kind of the whole reason we're here. So as I said in the beginning, I am not quitting YouTube, and I apologize for talking so much, but I hope that some of you maybe who are thinking about doing this or any other creative endeavors that put you at the mercy of outside factors, you know, the market and other people's opinions and the time, because sometimes you do the right thing at the wrong time and you have to be prepared for that. I hope that some of this stuff will come in handy. And if there's anything more I can do for you, if there's anything I can share, feel free to, you know, leave the comments below. One thing I would like to ask all of you is, if you could maybe leave a few more comments on my videos, because there's nothing I enjoy more. As I said earlier, I was joking, of course, I do walk outside of the studio sometimes, but a big part of what I do is solitary. I sit here and I play. And YouTube for me is this amazing opportunity to know people and to meet people from all over the world. The biggest number of viewers on my channel come from my favorite city in the whole world, which is New York. And then there's London, and then there's Sydney, and then there's Frankfurt and Madrid and Barcelona and Milan and Rome and Taiwan and Tokyo. And to me, that's amazing. But sometimes it feels a bit one-sided, and I would really love to get to know you guys better. So any opinion you have, any ideas you have, any suggestions you have, or simply any comments you might want to leave, please do. It will make me extremely happy. Thank you so much, as always, for being there, and I'll see you next week.